When the fascists came on July 7th, 1941, my brothers, the boys from the neighborhood, and I were in the street playing. We heard soldiers shouting, so we ran home and told my parents. Announcements hung on the lampposts ordering Jewish families to go to the town of Yatki. There were rumors that we were going to be killed there. Our father gathered us and took us to a neighbor's family. With tears in his eyes, he begged them for help to hide us. They agreed. We stayed for 4 months in a barn cellar, and they helped us with whatever they could. My mother was pregnant. She gave birth to my brother there. But my mother was afraid that it was very hard, both morally and financially, for that family to keep us, and she decided that father should ask another family to hide us. So we moved our hiding place to a family we had been friendly with before the war. This family lived in poverty, but shared what little food they had with us. Very often we stayed hungry and cold, shivering from the thought that police and fascists might find out, and that this kind family would suffer because of us. My mother didn't have any milk to nurse the baby, so she made a doll out of cloth, put some breadcrumbs inside, and let the baby suck on this. With God's help, we somehow survived. I was blonde and blue-eyed and was often sent with my father or the family's son to go to the village to beg for food. Sometimes soldiers stopped us, accused us of bringing food to the partisans, took the bread from us, beat us, and we were left with nothing. I carried a razor in my boot so that if I was captured, I could slit my throat so as not to give away our hiding place. I was only 12 years old at the time. Humiliation, hunger, cold, this is what our family endured. While I am writing this, tears come to my eyes. May the warm sun always shine for you. Isaac.